Lights, camera, action. It's TJ Smooth here, playing one of the great epic games ever. Oldie but a goodie classic, Sailor Moon 64. I call it the boss battle match. It's footage of me playing, fighting against the bosses, antagonists within this video game. Sailor Venus. First, in the beginning of the game, she helps you, but in the ending of the game, she becomes the antagonist, the bad villain. It's Sailor Moon with the powerful bombs. Have to collect those hearts. No. Not for good old Princess Serena. Damage level over 90%, unable to execute program, reporting back on sampling data. Next boss battle. Zoisite. Sailor Moon versus Zoisite at the Blue Resort. Versus Zoisite. Boom. Boom, 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 boom. I'm gonna kick this lady's ass. Once Sailor Moon does not have the heart, anyhow she gets hit, she'll be defeated. That takes care of Zoisite. I definitely kicked her ass. She sounds so funny in a phonetic high-pitched voice, like... Next boss battle? Versus... Nephilite. No! Oh, son of a bitch. Versus Ori. Players, whenever your character is unconscious, such as Sailor Moon here, any other player, just gotta rotate the control stick. Defeating Nephilite. No! That's what Nephilite saying. That's not the last you've seen of me, Sailor Moon. Here we have it. Another epic classic battle against Serena's main villain. Versus Tuxedo Mask. I'll show you what Tuxedo Mask can do. This is his dashing technique. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Ouch.
Holy shit. Talk about an epic knockout for Sailor Moon. I bet she's saying, "How could you do this to me, Tuxedo Mask? You're supposed to be the good guy fighting for a Sailor Scouts."
That was a fast battle.
Not bad. I underestimated you. However, you upset me. Prepare to meet your fate. Winged Guardian of the Green Resort on planet Earth. Normally before this happens, Sailor Venus would fly towards Sailor Moon and give her the remote control tiara. It would choose her the ability to use the remote control bombs from the summit of her tiara. Knocked out the winged guardian of the grassland.
You can knock out the man, man.
Yes.
Knock out the man, dear.
The bullet off. Down to the ground, biatch.
Man, I just love this power bomb.
Talk about roasted tail. By the way, players, if you collect at least 50 or 100 gems, you win the game. You actually win a new life. By the way, gotta stay away from water. Bomberman can't swim. Stage clear.
Here we have it, another rematch against Nephilite. The Hot Avenger, Nephilite, the Red Knight. Nephilite's eye lasers. That's right, Selena, pump up that, Selena, pump up that bomb. That bomb's a blow up. I've got a present for you, Nephilite. Burn, motherfucker, burn! And the Sailor Scouts won victory again. Guardian of the White Glaciers. That was a little glitchy there. Get down, stay on the ground, intergalactic glacial freak. You're right back. Gotta make a little phone call. This is it, Queen Daryl's, the Negaverse. Queen Beryl's high-tech robots. Heat-seeking missiles as soon as it starts? The black hole. There's no reason why. There's a reason why the people call this place the Negaverse, because they have the dark hole. It looks black. The draft actually sucks you into another dimension. Yes, it is I, Queen Beryl's high-tech security robot. Here to protect the Negaverse, return from intruders. I bet Serena's, let's say the moon say,
yeah, that hurts, that hurts.
Tech Harvester, Part 2, begin! Normally in those situations... Hey, Queen Beryl, they weren't even kidding. Queen Beryl really has a really good security guard. But what can I say? The title says it all, players. And viewers at the moment. Takes care of the high-tech harvester. This is obviously Bomberman 64, but the graphics in this video game and the gameplay, the graphics and animation looks precisely like the anime cartoon Sailor Moon over the years, the early childhood years. This is it. And they've melted the pathway to get out, meaning that there's no escape from this match.
You wanna fight me?
Versus Queen Beryl. And the theme song on the stage sounds awesome. It's breathtaking and epic. Talk about melted Serena, melted Sailor Moon. Versus Queen Beryl. Miss. Miss, you son of a bitch. Miss, you bought it cheap. Now Queen Beryl transforms into heavy metallic Queen Beryl.
Take your time.
epic, coolest, funkiest version of kick-ass song of Sailor Moon vs. Queen Beryl ever. Super Queen Beryl. Queen of the Megaverse. Starting to get annoying. You do the damn computation.
In that part of the game when you get 100 golden cards and you fight against Queen Beryl, Sailor Venus actually destroys her with her crescent beam attack.
That's only if you collect 100 golden cards.
And that scene in the game only shows up once, and there's no way to see it again unless you go to a new file and collect all 100 golden cards within the subworlds within the game.
Exactly like the fictional character from anime. Spellmaker is the queen and king of hallucinations. No, have to avoid those. Giant foot. Came from a ghastly, psychotic son of a bitch. I did it. I made the ghost get lost. Now this is it. The final, most epic, breathtaking, majestic, and yet diabolical match ever. Takes place in outer space. Sailor V's. All this time thought Sailor V was a good person, and if they're being, unfortunately she's bad, but she has the army cube. She's one of the villains. The final battle. Final epic battle. Against Sailor Moon. Sailor Moon against Sailor Venus. Turn it up! The theme song of the game sounds cool. Never seen this. Jeez. Saber Beast Crescent D. Not Saber Beast Crescent D. Great combination of punches. The Punching Man, like a tuxedo mask. Destroys the Omnicube. Take over the entire galaxy. Oh, what a choke. Hey, Meatball Man, I'll take care of you later. First need to get rid of her. Sailor Venus. Awesome, this mission takes place in outer space. Sailor Venus. Thank you.